interested in the differences. And I was wanting to really have a debt counselling club where people really did have papier-mâché boulders that corresponded to their bank balances. And in the film or video we're doing now, they're just meant to be that whole idea as a package.
Can you face the camera?
Gets represented in the film. Does it look worthwhile doing? Can you touch your chin again like you do?
I do feel like I've done the whole like hand for you though now. I don't. I've never given up on someone before, but.
You guys have got it wrong, you used to be congratulated. Thank you. I don't seem to work in any way in a professional, conventional filmmaking way. What do you mean? I have a slight reaction to the professional film industry. I respect it, but for some reason I want to work in a much more low economy and hand-to-mouth way.
Heavy and very slow.
And very much allowing spontaneity.
Is there any light if she comes up here? Does she get caught by the light?
My mum's a professional set designer. She's a production designer. And she's won an Oscar for Howard's End with Merchant Ivory.
Okay, film this with the more crouching
stakes. Some of my earliest memories are being on a film set, playing, and with my brother, and we were having a lot of fun, and everyone on the film set was really great with us. They were welcoming.
It's okay, you're doing really well.
I remember we used to smash up sort of doors with chains so that the doors had sort of chips, as if it looked as if it had been lived in, and other sort of film tricks.
If you want to, we can offer you, which seems to really work, is eating really, really harsh horseradish, just amazingly. Jacob was nearly in tears, all good. Would you like to do that? Lucy's gay, Marta's smiling.
Eat it quickly and then move your hand away from it fast. Yeah, well done, well done, well done.
The group I work with, I problem solve with them, and I test the ideas to the group I'm going to put the performance on at the end. They understand the ideas, they like them. The group's made up of quite a random group of people anyway,
and
from different backgrounds. And so that's the lock at that moment when you realise that the group enjoy all of the humour and all of the references. Normally that will be a successful communication to an audience, and that's, I've found it very straightforwardly.
Do you know sewing machine pinning? I don't know.
But
if you do it like this, the sewing machine can go over it. But
okay.
I don't mind. So this is like a, how do I put it? This is like a spare 3 hours, something like that, where we can make the costumes ready for the performances that are coming up. It's like a kind of moment, a day before the opening where you could go and relax, but in fact it's really useful just to get ahead of some of the workload. Get some of the things mended and make sure that the guys who are performing feel like they're slightly loved or slightly looked after. This one is, you know, in Star Wars there's this animal called a Wookiee, or this creature called a Wookiee, that Chewbacca is really well known for being a Wookiee. So these are Wookiee children. This is a Wookiee child. I think they're going through a sort of teenage crisis and they've dyed their hair pink or something like that. I don't know what it is. Oh my God, you're making pink fur go everywhere.
It's tiny.
That's good. I made it for a small person. I made it for a small person.
But I'm not a small person.
Oh my God. You see, and it needs... Can you see the layers I was talking about? So this is done. This is finished. But turn around, honey. And look, these are the layers that I was talking about that are missing. But guess what? We can't find in Nottingham any of this brilliant, fuzzy, pink, cheap fur that's only £1.99 a packet. So I have this extremely thin pink fur to have to compensate with. So I'm just going to have to get on with it and do that. You can't fixate thinking, oh my God, we haven't done this bit or something. When someone's looking at the costume in all, it has an effect. And then also when the person who's an audience is looking at all the different costumes and all the different things going on, the many layers, it all adds up. So I'm quite aware that I'm not fixating on things, which sounds like I don't have any quality control again. But I'm just kind of bashing things out, and I know that the end result has a much better energy than if you were trying to do everything meticulously and didn't manage to get an overall, I don't know, like, sense of it.
I think Marvin Gaye Chetwynd's work is seriously funny. I mean that in every sense. It's all about pleasure, joy, exuberance, laughter. But I think it's quite a radical laughter. It's almost kind of childlike joy, resituated in an adult field of references and in an adult context, is something that everyone can engage with.
The way of exhibiting in the art world on a high profile level is in museums, where there's a lot of people coming in who are expecting to be given the same experience each hour of the day the museum's open. But instead, oddly, I've been really stretched and strained to produce a performative thing, a performative atmosphere performance to happen, like, the whole time the museum's open, which is incredibly strenuous. It's like making people into dancing monkeys or something. It's impossible. You can do it for a time that makes sense to you, and then you have to be relaxed or normal. The phrase that I've been given by Turner Prize Experience was that I have to make my work more robust to handle the amount of public that would be happy to see it. So I'm meant to meet the demand rather than it being able to be that I can say, no, no, that's impossible. I really need to only do once a week for 1 hour. It's the answer I found is through film, because of the people like the Marx Brothers making their brilliant films, that you can manage to make a film that's really chaotic and full of mayhem, and that an audience would experience that as if they were experiencing a live performance. So I've actually seemed to be slipping into making film. Really important. you can't ever get away with statements, it seems. It's as if we're not allowed to be that confident or something like that. Everyone would criticise you too quickly. So rather than have a clean, clear statement, I'm posing questions, which is almost the manipulative way to get away with being political. Different waves of like energy within it, where it's like we're meant to somehow be intensely partying for 4 hours, but at the moment there have been really good waves of like moments that have felt really like perfect, and then there's other moments where you can tell everyone really wants to go to the real backstage, like relax for a bit. So it's an odd thing where you have to like timetable times to relax and times to be forever, like, in some way performing. There's three different elements seem to be working, like the puppets and the dancers seem to work. And the Star Wars film really works when the song, when the numbers happen. And also, there's enough for people to see, like, even if they're coming in when things aren't really necessarily at a peak, I do think there's a lot to appreciate. It's like a something that could be considered very dangerous, like a cult or overly sort of like controlled, but it's all volunteered and held together for a short period of time and then it is over. I let go. I'm not trying to build something. I find that people do appreciate it on many levels. So I don't feel that I'm in trouble with this. I feel like it's really natural and I'm quite confident that the referencing I do somehow communicates. And that's weirdly why people keep asking me to do projects. It is that it communicates. It's over. It's over.